Hello, it's Darren here from Gigglepin, and today I am going to walk you through how to install the two-speed into a single motor top housing. First things first, let's see what we have got in the box. You should find that you have one central gear cluster, one pinion gear cluster, one bearing and adapt assembly, one drill jig, which will be of two parts. You'll have the main locator, which fits the 10mm drill bit, and then inside that there should be a smaller insert for the 4mm drill bit. One air piston, one nut, one M10 Doughty washer, one ball bearing, one actuation shaft, one 10mm drill bit, and one 4mm drill bit. Additional tools that you may need: you'll need a drill, a half inch socket and ratchet, 15mm spanner, circlip pliers, a mallet, threadlock, grease, protective gloves, cleaning wipes, and maybe a blowtorch. To ensure years of trouble-free service, this kit must be fitted by a competent mechanic or engineer. If you are in any doubt, please contact us and we will recommend a suitable person to do this for you. Remove the top housing from your winch, remove all components and clean the top housing thoroughly. You should start with an empty top housing as pictured here. You need to remove the original wall bearings from your top housing. The easiest way to do this is to apply heat on the outside of the housing using a blowtorch. Then tap the outside with a mallet to force it to pop out. Locate the drill jig, including the 4mm insert, and insert it into the bearing bore in the top housing. Using the 4mm drill bit supplied, drill a 4mm hole through the top housing. Using the 10mm drill bit supplied and the jig with the 4mm insert removed, drill a 10mm hole through the top housing. Clean off any burrs from drilling and clean out any remaining debris. Remove the nut from the air piston. Add a small globule of threadlock onto the thread on the air piston, making sure that the Doughty washer remains in place. Insert the air piston thread first into the 10mm hole you have just made from the outside of the top housing. Find the nut and tighten the nut onto the air piston by hand to avoid cross-threading. Next, you will need a half inch socket and a 15mm spanner. Using the half inch socket on the nut and the 15mm spanner on the air piston, tighten the nut to make a secure fix. Locate the bearing and adapter assembly, making sure that the flat side is facing downwards, then insert it into the bearing aperture in the top housing. Using a pair of circlip pliers, carefully remove the circlip from the bottom of the central gear cluster. Remove the larger gear sets from the cluster. Apply some grease onto the actuation shaft. Look into the top of the central gear cluster and you will see a rod that the actuation shaft needs to line up with. Apply some grease into the hole of the actuation shaft. Put the single ball bearing into the hole with the grease. You can use a small screwdriver to push it in further. Insert the lower gears into the top housing with the smaller gear facing outwards. Insert the small cluster into the gears with the ball bearing ring facing out towards you. Make sure that the gear carrier bearing adapter is in place as it is sprung loaded and may have moved. You can see it sprung loaded here. Using the circlip pliers, insert the circlip back onto the shaft to lock the gears in position, making sure that the flat face of the circlip is facing towards the gear. If necessary, you can use a screwdriver to help push the circlip into place into its alignment recess. as the engagement spring will try to push it outwards. Line up the shaft with the ball bearing adapter assembly you already placed in the housing. Apply some pressure to push the central gear cluster firmly into place, and the gears should rotate freely. Place the housing cover O-ring into place. Place the pinion gear into the left side of the top housing cover. Replace the top housing cover, aligning the pinion gear with the central gear cluster and the motor hole in the back of the top housing. Fit the retaining screws to the cover. That's it. Congratulations. You have now assembled your two-speed gear set. Happy winching.